Anger on the streets of Lagos, protesting the government's removal of fuel subsidies. The price of gas has doubled, and many see it as too heavy a burden.
The effect on the economy, on the masses, is quite harsh. It's very oppressive. The cost of transport have doubled, food, everything.
As the protest grows, the economy shrinks.
It seems more like a real restaurant, and I'm just amazed by how empty my voice is, like bouncing off the walls.
If you have been here at our peak periods,
yeah,
then you'll know what we're losing. You'll have an idea of what we're losing. This place is empty.
Fooke Akinleye has been running Tasty Fried Chicken, a popular Nigerian fast food chain, for the last 15 years. But today, nothing is cooking.
How does it make you feel?
Sad. Not just for us, but for the nation. Because if we're losing, what about our suppliers? It just goes down the line. Things are going downhill. It's really disheartening.
There are no customers anywhere. Lagos, the business heart of Nigeria, has become a ghost town.
We're here in what is normally one of Lagos' busiest shopping malls, the Palm. Normally, on any given day, this place would be jam-packed, full of cars, a beehive of activity, people streaming in and out of this place. There's a supermarket, there's a movie theater, there are restaurants. This place would just be jam-packed, heaving.
Inside, more of the same. Padlocks on the doors. But it's not just the well-to-do who are hurting. In the shadow of posh suburbs, the poor are skipping meals.
When I told somebody this is 70 naira, 100 naira, he will say, he will just, you know, feel sad. When he feels sad, sometimes he will say, give me garri. Then some will say, give me biscuits. They will buy water, finish. They will leave about the bread because they cannot afford it. The money is not enough.
While many debate on how the strike affects Africa's most vibrant economy, for the majority of Nigerians who live on less than $2 a day, the impact is already felt. Vladimir Duthiers, CNN, Lagos, Nigeria.